The one thing about my grandfather is that he never went past third grade. So that really taught me that, you know, it's not about what credentials people bring, it's who they are, because in spite of never going past third grade, he was one of the smartest men I've ever known. One of the coolest things about my grandfather was he let us try anything once. So I chewed tobacco when I was five, I shot guns, I drove tractors, I went fishing. And that really ties in really well with DPR's core value of ever forward. You know, DPR isn't afraid to try new things. And if it doesn't work out, that's fine. As long as you learn something from it, we can try something new and not feel like we have to continue down a wrong path. It's okay to regroup and say, yeah, I didn't really like tobacco. Move on. I didn't come to DPR right away in my career. I had 10 years of experience before coming to DPR. And I was fortunate enough to have a very solid foundation in building and engineering skills in that 10 years, but I wasn't inspired. I would say that my husband is a teacher, and he has a calling to be a teacher. And for the longest time in my career, I felt like I just had a job. And I was jealous that he had this calling in life, and I feel like I have found my calling at DPR. I believe in the integrity of the organization, in our leadership, and the collaborative team atmosphere in which we approach everything that we do really speaks to me and who I am. I don't think of myself as a female regional manager. I think of myself as a regional manager. And really, that doesn't even do much for me, because I truly believe in a servant leadership model. My role is to help everyone else be successful. DPR is very non-hierarchical, and I believe that to my core. It actually bothers me when people talk about who's their boss, and it's all about roles and responsibilities and how can I best help someone be the best that they can be every day. I do feel a sense of responsibility to show a work-life balance, to show that we can work hard at work and be successful, but then that we make the right amount of time for our families, because that's what we're all here for. I have been known to pull a prank or two. At regional manager meetings, people tend to want to sit facing me. I've been known to start a few food fights. We had a marketing end of the year dinner celebration, and they served us some very stinky cheese that we all avoided like the plague. But then at the end of the evening, we decided that we needed to get a little piece of that cheese in the pocket of one of the gentlemen who's now on our board of directors. I may have decided and then coerced someone kind of new to the company to give that person a hug and slip it in their pocket. And then they found it, you know, a couple weeks later after it had gotten really good and smelly. So building great things means building not just our construction projects, but building our communities and building our teams and our lives and you know, touching every aspect of what we do and having that pride that my grandfather taught me about, you know, doing everything that I do to the best of my abilities.